Yowza!
I got another Gits fish. Okay, we still got the pop-up effects. Some black ice, which actually just got an update this morning. I hadn't been really paying attention to the in-development build, but I think the last time I saw an update to this game was like over a year ago. But it's actually a very compelling kind of shooter. Let me go ahead and, I mean, the UI is gorgeous. I love this new look. It is absolutely amazing how this has gotten a facelift since the last time I looked at it. And so now we're going to... Excuse me. We're just going to do a fresh start here. For one thing, I had a couple of pretty broken builds. So, basic tutorial. And then... I'm gonna hack the server. So basically, it's a cyberpunk shooter. You gotta fight off these. You're a hacker. You're trying to basically become. Ooh, very nice. And you're trying to take down the corrupt system, etc., etc. One thing that wasn't in the last build I played was double jump standard. So you can sprint, you can jump, you can now double jump. You got your weapons, you got your icebreaker. You see the down in the corner, it's actually mostly hidden behind my camera here, but this is your RAM is sort of your energy bar and various programs like the icebreakers and the weapons will actually use up that RAM, I think. Yeah, if you're shifting, that uses up some. Jumping, double jumping. There's also looks like a parkour lift, kind of like they added to Halo 5, which is really interesting. So it looks like there's a lot more emphasis on sort of physicality and, you know, maneuvering, stuff like that around the map. Definitely gonna give that a try. Gonna level up here. Spend a talent point. Actually, you know what? Hold on. I don't want a name like Bobby Tables. Why is Bobby Tables a thing? There we go. It's probably gonna send me... Yeah, I'm level zero, so it's gonna send me back to the beginning of the tutorial. I should have seen that coming. But, so basically what happens is, you come up, you activate your icebreaker, which is a cyberpunk term for intrusion countermeasures. Basically, anybody who's remotely familiar with the Netrunner card game and the Android universe that takes place in is going to be pretty much familiar with a lot of this stuff. You got your intrusion countermeasures, or your ice, which are these enemies. What's interesting is there are ways to actually... Ooh, is that a new program? Picked up a new double jump. Let's see. Attack speed plus 2. This is actually better than the one I've got. Better jump height too. Very nice. Off the tutorial even. So, level up. Health RAM, hack speed, weapon damage, weapon range, crit chance. You know what? I like being able to have options. I'm going to bump that up. Exit the tutorial zone. Holy guacamole. Look at all this. Black Cat module, weapon range plus 3 meters, RAM plus 3. Oh, yeah. I love these passive mods. So now we can go over here and check out this shop. Yeah. High threat, so if I decide to hack this building, I'm probably gonna die. Shops are extremely dangerous. Okay, so yeah, I've got super jump here. Buy for 520. How much do I have? 5. Because of course I do. Sell all inventory items. That gives me 60 to work with. So epic, yeah. A heal is really nice to have. I just don't have enough money for any of this stuff. Clearly, I need to fix that. Hello. 50 XP. Yeah, this is... It sounds like the map is actually, like, handcrafted now from what I was reading in the patch notes that Garrick put out. It's, you know, it's meant to feel more physical, and there's a much bigger emphasis on, like, a little bit of parkour. Like, buildings don't just vanish when you're done hacking them now. They actually stay around. You can see through them, but... let's see. So what do we got over here? Yeah, there's finality. Looks like everything down here is level 1. You can see allied corporations. So basically, if I hack this server, I'm also going to be hacking this server. I have no way around that. Very, very interesting. I love this new map. This looks like, and he did say there's like boss arenas? Is this one of those boss arenas? Huh. Yeah, this is level 10. I don't think I want to be hacking this yet, but... Okay, so that's a power-up. Maybe that's a power-up, too. Uh-huh. It is. Okay, good to know. So yeah, some of these servers are actually like boss arenas now, to where they aren't just, it's not just a big server that you fight, but it's actually, like, there's actually more to it than that. I can climb this way. Got a nice program here, another Black Hat module. Hack time -5 seconds. Loot find. Always a fan of loot find. It's cyberspace, so there's no fall damage, of course. But yeah, there's just definitely a bigger emphasis on exploration. I like that. I like that a lot. It's not just gear and more gear and more gear. Oh, if I get in over my head, you'll hear me scream. For example, let's give this a shot, shall we? just hack two servers at once. Ow. Go away! Leave me alone! Stupid pop-ups! Ooh, I got a Gitz fish. And I'm out of... I'm gonna be out of health here in a minute. Ow. Ow. Oh, of course it's a level 3. No wonder. Okay. Thank you. Alright, what'd I get? What'd I get? A level. That's what I got. Let's ramp up hack speed a bit. Perks. Ooh. Perk points are currently granted at levels 10, 20, and 30. Aim hacks, all snipers home in. Oh! Discipline, launch up to 5 discs. Hubris, colorizing enemies, turns them to your side. Laser guns pierce through all objects. These are pretty snazzy. I know that was in like the build before the one I'm on now, but... Alright, so what have I got? I've got a sniper, a shotgun, and it gets fish. I shall call you Scarlett Johansson. We're gonna call that a shotgun. I call shotgun. Hello. Ow, 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 ow. Forgot scorpions had lasers. I'm sorry, scorporations. It's so cyberpunk, it hurts. Hurts so good. Oh yeah. Ow! There we go. Proximity mine. Ooh, I like mines. Mines are fun. You know what? That's what I'm gonna do. I guess there's a cooldown. Alright, so let's have some fun, shall we? Mine, 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 mine. Now, here's a trick. What happens if I hack two servers of different colors? They go after each other as well as me. There we go, got another level. Put some points in health. What'd I get? EMP! Let's go ahead and... Well, that's a basic one. Better accuracy, but accuracy on a mine? I don't know. Alright, let's give this a shot on something else here. Those look like two different shades of purple. Oh, did the bot smack you? Yeah, it thinks that anything dot something is a web link, so... Let's ramp it up! Is a teleport. And it gives me better movement speed. Yes, please. So now, instead of sprinting, ooh. Oh, Gary, you outdid yourself with this one. I like the graphic effect on that teleport. It definitely feels like a teleport, not a glitch now. And I just got a disc weapon. So... let's go ahead and drop that in. Noob icebreaker, basic icebreaker. It's got better hacking speed. These are exactly the same. So I'm gonna drop that in there. Okay. Oh yeah. I am Chrono Strider once more. All right, let's do this. Let's go ahead and take on that one, that one, and that one. Something's sniping at me. Oh, right. Disc. I don't have a shotgun anymore. Yowza! I got another Gitz fish. Okay, we still got the pop-up effects. I love that physics glitch. It's my favorite. Yeah, I'm still going at, I'm still hacking this one. Gotcha. Got an aimbot. Got a mass driver. Got another talent point. Yeah, we're getting some good stuff here. Let's see about... okay, rare shotgun. Common aimbot. I still kind of like the Gitz fish. 120 health. Ooh, this one's better. 37.5 shotgun. The thing that's going to be better than the disc. For now, at least. This, I can kind of get out of here. 27 DPS, 33 DPS. Which aimbot's gonna be better? This one? Because, ooh, Ice Bolt freezes targets. Keep that as a backup. Yes. I wonder if... yep, it works vertically too. Oh, yeah, I remember that. That's a little Easter egg. So, we're level 4. I'm curious. What happens if we do this? Yup. Nice music. Okay, yeah, I'm going personal with these guys. Yeah, having that EMP bomb is a definite benefit. Nice. Rainbow bolt. Well, hello, there's stuff down there. Very interesting. Okay. Now, didn't I see... One of these buildings had something on top of it, didn't it? Okay, here we go. So this is a dark server. So called because you can't see. There's a cloaking effect on all these enemies. But given the enemies have one hit point each, it looks like it's a level 1. Alright. There you are. Got another rainbow bolt. Epic sniper, common sniper, chance to colorize. Yeah, this one's definitely better. But... there's something up there. And there's something up there. I got XP. Sweet. Yeah, this is... Oh man, I could have some fun with this game again. I love exploration and parkour type navigation. And this is right up my alley, these new updates. I love this. This is incredible. I don't know about you, Prinny, but I kind of want to get, you know, the gang back together, so to speak, and get back into this and try it out, because this is cool stuff. Oh yeah, it's got multiplayer. It's actually got PvE and PvP toggles, basically, so... And it will not let me out this way, probably until I clear this boss arena. I'm level 4. I got a Gitz fish. I'll be fine. I'm so dead. So freaking dead. Ow! Okay, that was painful. Health, please.
When does that hurting stop?
I forget, do we ever have like a name for that particular physics glitch, or was it just, you know, the sky high bounce or whatever? I just did that at level 4. Alrighty. So, it's looking like, yeah, there's a huge. Yeah, this is a big change. This is a big level boost. But yeah, the fact that there's so many rewards now for actually just going and exploring and trying to, you know, jump on things. I wonder if jetpacks ever got neutered. Because I remember jetpacks, you could go for quite a while. I remember they got nerfed once, but let's see. Jump, teleport. Go. Another blink. Better hack range, better teleport distance. Yes, this game. Well, I don't know if they got, like, removed for balance reasons. I'd have to actually look it up. But, yes, jetpacks. So, yeah, I definitely want to clear out all of this in my single player game before I even think about going and taking on all of that. Look at that, level 38, level 8, and level 24. Level 39, Allied Corporation. And then way off in the distance is the big one. Yeah, definitely gonna need to sell some stuff, but I don't want to sell off everything, so I'll definitely be coming back to this at a later date. But yeah, this is another game. It's kind of like Counterspell in that it's a decent game for single player if you're just looking to focus on, you know, challenging yourself and you know, improving your gear on your build and everything. But it really shines in multiplayer, because then you can have everybody teaming up and, you know, making your builds like complementary and supplementary to each other. And this is it right here. The final boss server. And you can actually go inside now, because it's a boss arena. Level 50! Used to be like level 100. So this is gonna be the end of the stream, but I'm going to go out on a stupid note. I'm gonna die! I'm so going to die. Ow, ow, ow. Yep. I died. All right, that's it for my indie showcase stream. I will definitely be putting these videos up on YouTube, and this is definitely something I want to keep doing. I'm gonna scan through my Steam library and see if I can find anything else that's like just a small indie kind of game to add to the list, because I think some of this stuff could count towards my bounties too, for my backlog, so I'm definitely gonna look into that. This was fun. I'm probably gonna do some bounties later, probably this evening. I do have work tomorrow and Wednesday, but then I'll be back at it on Thursday for another stream, and Friday. Yeah, tonight around maybe 6-ish Arizona time, I'll be going back into Shovel Knight, try to get some more progress on that, and once I get frustrated with that enough, I'll probably switch over and make some more progress in The Witness. So that's the plan for tonight. In the meantime, thanks for everybody who stopped by, and I'll catch everybody later.